We're going to lead off this Monday morning with word that the two provinces hardest hit in the pandemic are both taking a big step this week to get more people vaccinated. Ontario and Alberta are letting anyone 40 years of age or older get the AstraZeneca vaccine. People in that age group can start getting the shot as of tomorrow, as both of those provinces lower the eligibility age for the vaccine by 15 years. AstraZeneca has been approved in Canada by Health Canada for anyone 18 years of age and older. But doses have been going to people over 55 on the advice of the National Advisory Committee on Immunization, NACI, as it's commonly known. Right now, Ontario and Alberta have the highest active case rates in the country. And as we've been reporting, new COVID cases driven by the widening spread of variants are threatening to overwhelm Ontario's hospitals in particular. So we begin this morning with Natalie Colata, taking a closer look at this decision to expand the eligibility. Natalie, give us some more of these details. Good morning.
Good morning, Heather. Well, as you mentioned, this is big news and for a lot of people who have been anxious to get this vaccine, both in Ontario and Alberta, now able and eligible to get the AstraZeneca vaccine if you are over the age of 40, where previously it was at 55. This is a shot that will be offered as soon as potentially tomorrow at pharmacies, primary care settings as well. And you may remember earlier this spring, NACI, as you mentioned, did issue a concern saying that they recommend individuals over the age of 55 only receive this vaccine after a small group of younger individuals in Europe developed a serious blood clot of that condition. But as we're seeing now, they're now reviewing the information that Health Canada has now put forward. Two provinces, Alberta and Ontario, as you mentioned, jumping right on this. Alberta Premier Jason Kenney last night tweeting about this change, saying that there are going to be more details this morning, citing this growing knowledge about the vaccine for the age drop, as well as advice from his own provincial medical officer of health. CBC News also received a statement from the Ontario government that said the province made the call to drop that age to 40 based on what they call the current supply of vaccine. We know that the Ontario Pharmacies Association, who spoke to CBC, says there is a great need. Have a listen to what they had to say.
We need to take the vaccine to high-risk neighborhoods and places where access to health services is somewhat limited. There's no reason why we shouldn't be doing even more pop-up clinics. We can take the AstraZeneca vaccine and work in collaboration with physicians and pop up these clinics so that we can get even more people vaccinated.
That is the goal, but what about the demand? Well, we can tell you CBC also spoke to one Toronto pharmacist who says he has 160 doses of the AstraZeneca vaccine in his fridge, in his pharmacy, that is set to expire at the end of the month, and he has run out of patients over the age of 55 to give it to. In fact, he says that he's had to turn away individuals, younger people who have been desperate for this vaccine. So this will, of course, be good news for them. Have a listen to what he had to say.
It felt like, you know, a ship was sinking and you had a life raft and you just couldn't take anybody on board. It was heartbreaking. The amount of people that would have coming fearful for their lives is simply because they don't meet the right age category and their job is very high risk. They're seeing a lot of people in their job and you can't help them. It's just, it's not a good feeling to have to turn these people away.
And hopefully, Heather, he won't be able to have to turn as many away as that age limitation and eligibility now drops to 40 years of age in the province of Ontario and Alberta.
Okay, let us stay with Ontario for just a moment more, Natalie. As of this morning, as of right now, the province is stopping passenger vehicles from coming into the province from other provinces. Tell us about that measure.
That's right. We know that in Ontario, in Ottawa, police there have set up stations at all four checkpoints, all five bridges, as well as the two ferries linking the two provinces of Ontario and Quebec, also along the Manitoba border today. This is in response to the province of Ontario limiting travel within the province for what they call essential purposes only. So if you live or work in the province of Ontario, there's a child care or custody that you have to travel out or into the province, Indigenous treaty rights, medical or health care reasons, or if you have to travel through to get to somewhere else. So this is happening as Ontario is in the midst of its third wave. We know that field hospitals are starting to pop up, in a big one in Toronto at the Sunnybrook Hospital. You see it there on your screen there. That is expected to start readying patients today as the province there attempts to get a grip on their COVID numbers. Heather?
More than 4,200 yesterday reported once again. Natalie, thank you very much.